Sola gloria secca, dimissio vici. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the last glory.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the martyr Saint Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and sealed it in his blood, and confidently professed it by our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. You have followed my teaching, way of life, purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance, persecutions, and sufferings, such as happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra, persecutions that I endured. Yet from all these things the Lord delivered me. In fact, all who want to live religiously in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. But wicked people and charlatans will go from bad to worse, deceivers and deceived. But you remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work, the word of the Lord. The response to the psalm is, O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. Though my persecutors and my foes are many, I turn not away from your decrees. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. Permanence is your word's chief trait. Each of your just ordinances is everlasting. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. Princes persecute me without cause, but my heart stands in awe of your word. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. Those who love your law have great peace, and for them there is no stumbling block. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. I wait for your salvation, O Lord, and your commands I fulfill. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. I keep your precepts and your decrees, and for all my ways are before you. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Alleluia, from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to the Lord.
As Jesus was teaching in the temple area, he said, how do the scribes claim that the Christ is the son of David? David himself, inspired by the Holy Spirit, said, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I place your enemies under your feet. David himself calls him Lord. So how is he his son? The great crowd heard this with delight, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us now turn to the Father with confidence as we present our prayers of the petition, that the Church may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may grant all Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, that we come together with our offerings and to your sacred altar, God, that through that purifying action of your grace we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord of God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever, to give you thanks, Lord, for your Father, Almighty, eternal God, and for Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with hope, and so with all the angels and saints with praise, as we bow down to our praying.
Holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are in the glory of the Father, all holiness and many glory. Therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and undergoing the gift of his confession, he prayed. Given the thanks, walked and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more given the thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith we proclaim with that, Lord, and promise your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving and thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered in the number of your spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with us of hope and grace of bishop and Lord of clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, that calling us living a hope of the resurrection, Lord, have died in mercy. Welcome and thank you to the light of faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, the Most Holy Spouse, the Blessed Apostle, with St. Zachary, with St. Boniface, and all the saints that please you of our ages, we may merit to be coerced with the light, and may praise and glorify you through his Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father,
deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil, our precious, to grant peace in our days, and that by the power of your mercy may we always free from sin and save from all distress, as we Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, before the hem of the veil to lay the sins of the world, blessed are those who form the staff of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
In the Bible,
amen.
Before final blessing, let us pray. Let us bless our school and families. May Almighty God send his blessing upon our school, upon our children, upon our teachers, and upon them, their parents. May God protect them during their vacation time and refresh them so they can come back with a new zeal for learning. We ask this in the Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The message is ended for peace.
Thanks be to God.